We met very young. Somebody introduced us at a local fair. I wasn't sure at first. And he said, can I call you? And I said, well, you know, we'll see. And then he called and called and called, and I finally answered, so yes. I was only 14, I was going to be 15, and he was a year older. He went into the Army right after high school and was an MP there. He really enjoyed it. And then years after, he decided the Port Authority, the bigger department, was for him. We were only married like 2 years, 3 years, and then we decided to have children. And that was his whole world. That is my best memory of him. It was that good a father. Exceptional. We were married for 10 years, a little over 10 years, yes.
I describe him as a big personality. We were friends for about 9 years before we started dating. Not long after, we were house hunting and, you know, had a baby, got married, and it just felt right and it was easy. And being a dad was definitely his top priority. Very involved father. He was very active in the kids with their sports, family game nights, or we'd have movie nights. He loved his job. You know, our kids learned what it was like to be in a firehouse from infancy. They learned what it was like to get up and leave a dinner table, to go on a call, to go help someone else in need. He was a volunteer fireman for the Islip Fire Department for 28 years. Two of those years, he served as chief of department, and he was a member of the FDNY for 21 years.
Ray, he was fun-loving, great husband, great father, an amazing cop. He wore his uniform with pride. We met at a club. My friend said, oh, by the way, he said he saw you and he said, I want her. So he begged me for my number, I don't know how many times. And after that, we were together ever since. And he proposed to me on my birthday.
Well, I was working a little part-time job. I dropped my children off at their grandmother's to watch. And Bill had to go into New York. And on the train, there was someone making a lot of commotion, smoke, and a lot of noise, really upsetting people. And Bill told him who he was, that he was a plainclothes policeman. He started getting rough with Bill. And Bill said, I'm going to make you get off at the next stop. So the doors opened and they hopped off and the guy started a fight. Both fell down on the train tracks and the guy pulled out a gun and shot him 4 times. And I went to my mother-in-law's house to pick the kids up and there was a policeman and he knocked and he said, there's going to be somebody from Port Authority to take you to the hospital. And when I got in there, I remember it clear as anything. They said, oh, he's in room so-and-so. And I said, oh, maybe he's okay if he's in the room. But when I got to the room, it was... My husband was 32 years old. Children were 5 and 6 at the time. Every single day, they put their lives on the line. And not many people's jobs are like that.
Training at work was normal. You know, especially him being in Rescue 2, because you need to be on top of your game. He was already at work that morning. The kids went to school, I went to work, and I saw a number that I didn't know come up, and it looked like it was a City of New York number, so I answered it. And they told me there was an accident at work. She wasn't sure of the severity of it, and that someone was coming to pick me up. I was picked up and brought to Kings County Hospital in Brooklyn. My mom picked them up from school, and then I called them from the hospital, and I let them know, you know, that he had fallen and had an accident. Companionship, just having that person. He saved 5 lives. He donated his heart, his liver, his lungs, and both of his kidneys. He spent his whole career doing something selfless and being a fireman and sacrificing himself for others. And then even dying, he did the same thing. It just kind of speaks to who he was, I feel.
Thank you. I'm just walking and rushing to work, and the guy from the concierge told me, Carmen, you heard what happened. I'm like, what do you mean, what happened? The World Trade Center has been hit. So I ran out the building, and all of a sudden, I see that second plane hit the building. At that moment, I said, I'm not gonna see my husband in a couple of days, because I know he's down there, he's probably helping. His partner's wife called me and asked me if I heard from him, and I said, no, what's going on? He's missing and he's not answering his radio, no one can get through. And at that moment, I actually fell to the floor and was screaming, and all my neighbors were coming to me to find out what's happening, and I was just yelling on the phone, and he never came home. I just gotta say, he was such an amazing father and husband and friend. He was everything to me. He was my soulmate.
It was harder on them than I thought. They were so young, I didn't think it wouldn't be too bad. I tried helping them. I don't think I did enough sometimes, but I tried to do the best I could.
Things change and you become mom and dad all in one breath, and the good cop and the bad cop, all that changes, like, quickly.
My husband was found on December 19. We had to bury him 3 days before Christmas.
This past April, he would have been 75. And other than family, I look back and I feel so bad that he's not gonna be remembered. And then, every year, I open the mailbox. If I see that answer the call on the envelope, I can literally have tears in my eyes because they're saying, we can only imagine what you went through. We're sorry for it. We're never gonna forget him.
It took me a while before I finally went to the first gala. And then I understood more what this organization does for the families and what they represent.
There were funeral bags all over the place. There was Christmas presents unwrapped all over the place. My tree was up. I mean, we were a hot mess. Stephen and his wife sat down. And I was like, I'm so sorry, let me. And she's like, nope, no worries. She literally picked some toys up off of one of my chairs, sat down next to me and chatted with them. They just showed up at my doorstep with a check for $50,000 and didn't ask a single question. They literally showed up to check on me and my kids. They were just here to support us. They weren't looking around, they were just looking at me, talking to me.
You think you're gonna live for years and years and years. You don't realize something might happen, but anything can happen to them any day that they go off to work.
They're just regular people, and they go out there in danger every day. Our daughter, Jillian, she followed his footsteps and became a NYPD police officer and is wearing his badge proudly.
You can only have so much sad. You know, we got to go to the Mets game and my kids got to help throw the first pitch, and it wasn't about, yeah, we're helping you monetarily, but this is what we have going on. We want to make sure you can attend, and that was important.
The staff is incredible, and I am absolutely honored to be a part of this organization because they do take care of their own.
If you're looking to support an organization that is truly going to support the first responders and their families, with no questions asked, answer the call of the organization.
Thank you for answering the call.
Thank you so much for never forgetting.
Thank you for your support.